The turbos are coming off. Been a couple weeks since I've done an update video here. Been traveling a little bit and just hadn't made quite as much progress with the car as I had hoped. But we're back today as I've finally gotten to a pretty good point to go ahead and share an update with you guys. Last video, I had just finished up all the preventative maintenance on it. My plan was to jump into fueling and get all of the fueling set up from that point. I do have the port injection all set up and ready to go. The manifold just needs to go on. And I did get the fuel pump out of the car, but I do still have to build the fuel pump because I bought the DIY kit to save $100 and something. And so I need to take that apart and get it built. I didn't install any of this yet just because the rear turbo inlet is still on the car, and getting this on there with the rear turbo inlet on there is a little bit of a challenge, but that inlet has to come off anyways, and so it just makes sense to go ahead and pull the inlet off first to make this a little bit easier to get on. Got all the fueling stuff set up, but since then I've been working on dropping the subframe and actually getting to the turbos. We've gotten to that point, and today is the day that the factory turbos are coming off of the 135. So if you want to come on over here, we'll go ahead and give you a little bit of rundown of what I've done since then. So the subframe right here is still partially attached to the car. My plan was to completely drop it to make it easier to go ahead and replace the oil pan gasket under here, but I was having a huge pain in the ass issue with the steering rack here and the bolts that bolt up right here behind the brake rotor. These require you to put a T35 in here, which is like a very unique bolt. They actually don't make very many of those, and so I had to custom order them online, but you have to put a T35 in the top and then, you know, wrench the bottom part of this bolt here. And I just could not get these off. WD-40, put a bunch of solvent in there to try, but I just couldn't get them to budge. And so I actually completely stripped this one. And then on the other side, I broke my T35 bolt off inside of there. And so the T35 stuck in the top of that. So I just couldn't get these off to get the steering rack out of the way to completely remove the subframe. So the subframe's just hanging here. It's at least low enough for me to access everything that I need to access. And so I really wanted to get it removed, but it just wasn't worth the hassle to try to get this all the way off to get the steering rack bolts out. So we're just working with it like this for now. So over here on this side of the car, you can see that we have complete sight to the two turbos now. So I went ahead and removed the factory water pump, which sits right here, and the factory thermostat. And so I removed those. I removed all of the hoses associated with it. The motor mount support bracket sits right under here. That's been removed as well. I got the factory outlet out of here. And I have, I think, all of the oil lines out of here. And so the turbos are actually ready to come out. I spent a lot of time pulling on this front one to try to get the front one out, and it just wouldn't budge. And then I realized there is a third line here. And so all the way around the back side of this, which is probably pretty hard for you guys to see, but around the back side of this, there is actually a coolant feed line that feeds all the way up to the back side of the turbo. And I hadn't gotten those removed. And so I'll have to get this coolant line removed here, and then the front turbo should just pull right off. And then I need to get all of the mounting bolts to the manifold off on the rear one, and that should come out as well. So that's all I've got for now. I'm going to go ahead and get to working on getting the two turbos off, and I'll go ahead and show you guys once I'm able to get those out of there. All right, we got the front turbo off. Had a little bit more trouble than I thought I would. I didn't realize that the coolant line that connects to this is actually attached to the other turbo as well and doesn't split in the middle. And so I had to end up taking off one of the lines on here so that I could get the coolant line popped off of here. It just took a long time prying with a screwdriver, but we got it off. And now we are about to pull the rear turbo off. The other thing that I had to do as well, I had to remove this. I believe it's a coolant pipe because it hooks up to the water pump. And so I had to pull that pipe off just to get more access to get the front turbo out. But now the rear turbo should be completely unrestricted. It still is hooked up to the inlet back there. And so I'm just gonna try to muscle that one out. And also the vacuum line is still hooked to the wastegate here. And so once I get this off and can get a little bit more clearance, I'm just gonna cut the line off and shorten it a little bit, since pulling the vacuum line off of the wastegate is nearly impossible, as I learned with the first one. So I just had to go ahead and cut it like I did right there. So we're gonna go ahead and give this a yank and see if we can get it out of here. There we go. The 8 bolts that are up here to get this off, a couple of them are pretty easy to access, but some of them are a complete pain in the ass. It'd be really nice to have the subframe out of the way, because then you can just pop your head under right here and get a little bit easier access. But obviously don't have it off, and so it's kind of a pain to get those ones out, but seems like we're getting a little bit of movement here. I forgot that I still had the coolant hose right here connected to the top side of the turbo. It's pretty difficult to get an Allen wrench up there to loosen it to get that top one off. And so I just removed it from the block, but it snakes behind this turbo heat shield here. And so rather than trying to get this off, I just undid the 4 little bolts that hold this heat shield together. Now the turbo should come out. There we go. All right. Like I mentioned, the vacuum hose is still attached there. So we're just gonna sit this on the subframe. Grab some box cutters and saw this off. All right. That right there is both of the turbos off of the N54. And just for a little fun, we'll go ahead and show you the size of this tiny turbo right here compared to what we are putting in this. So as you can tell, this thing is just absolutely massive compared to these tiny stock turbos. So now that we've got both of these out, the next step is to start on the actual install process of getting the single turbo in there. I also got the other rear inlet out. And so now I'll be able to go ahead and install all of the port injection as well. I'll go ahead and get the fuel pump built and get the fuel pump installed. And then I'll start following the 41 steps that came with my Speedtech turbo kit. So we're finally done with all of the uninstall work. And so from here on, it's all install. So that wraps it up for this update video. We'll go ahead and continue to document the process as we go through the install to put the single turbo on there. And hopefully we'll be back with another update video soon.